Kyle, welcome to the Leanpub launch video for You Don't Know JS Yet, the Unbooks. I was wondering if you could take a moment just to talk to us a little bit about yourself and about your book and what it's about and who it's for and what you plan to do with it during this video.
All right. Well, thank you. Yeah, I'm back. This is an interesting chapter in what has been over a 10-year journey of mine writing the You Don't Know JS books. They started with the first edition published with O'Reilly. Way back in 2014 was the first of those books. And there were six books in that edition, and those did well. But I decided to go with self-publishing, which is when I found Leanpub back in maybe, I think, 2016 or 2017. And I kind of fought with O'Reilly for a bit, and I reacquired the rights to the You Don't Know JS mark so that I could redo or do a second edition of the books. And that the first of those came out and were published in 2020, right before the pandemic. I had this whole plan to do all six, like boom, 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 right in a row. Got two done, pandemic hit, and I just like lost all the motivation. So basically, what was going to be a six book second edition kind of languished for a while as a two book second edition. And then a couple of years ago, I decided I would try to gauge the interest level in the community because so much has changed. People don't really buy as many tech books these days as they used to. They're much more inclined to want to see YouTube videos or, you know, other things like that. So I wanted to kind of gauge that, and I ran a Kickstarter, and this was in, I think, 2022 or 2023. I've lost track of the years, but anyway, somewhere a couple of years back, ran a Kickstarter to see if I could get the final four books of the second edition written, fully edited, and then fully published. And just so everybody's kind of like aware, we peel back a little bit of the layer here since we're likely all authors here. So there's a lot that goes into publishing. There's the first part, which is just writing the content. And I actually find that part to be pretty easy. I don't mind sitting down and I can get into a flow. And I usually am writing from some deep well of something I've already thought about. So the writing part is not the big thing for me. Some people, that is where they get kind of blocked. But I have a really high standard for what I put out. So when I'm writing, I'm constantly editing myself as I write. And then I also go through multiple rounds, or I want to go and I strive to go through multiple rounds of additional editing from others. So there's structural and content editing, there's copy editing, there's things like that. And not every author goes through those steps, but because I had done work with a professional publisher before, I kind of had that bar for myself. I was like, I don't want these books to come out and be of lesser quality than what I used to put out before. So I went to the extra step of hiring editors. And in fact, they were my friends from O'Reilly. So I had worked with them before and I was just working with them as contractors. But I went through the editing process. So that's how all the first two books came out. And it's a lot of work. I would say maybe at least half of the work is the production process through all of those stages of editing. And then even once you get into Leanpub, as great as Leanpub's tools are, there's a lot of little details and nuances you have to go through in the typesetting, right? Like laying things out and making sure that things are structured well for an ebook experience. And so there's that work. And then it's even more work when you want to take your work and put it into print. Again, Leanpub is great because they have the export to be able to put something in like InDesign or whatever, but there's still a lot of work to kind of like force Leanpub to generate the right thing that you want to see on the other side, because it's more difficult to edit afterwards. And so that process, about 50% of the work, I went through that on the first two books, but I was like, oof, I don't know if I'm going to be able to justify all of that extra work for the remaining four books. And the Kickstarter campaign was designed so that I could have in layers, I could have one kind of the main funding level would say, I'll write the books. I'll write drafts of them. And then there was a stretch goal of like, I'll go through additional editing, and another stretch goal of I'll go through all the ebook, you know, production, the layout and all that other stuff. And then the final one was I'll go through all the work to do cover design and do a print and all of that, you know, management stuff. So the Kickstarter did well, but it did not reach any of those stretch goals. It did get funded, but it didn't reach any stretch goals. And so about 3 or 4 months after that campaign ended, I set out to like start writing. And I was going to at least write the drafts, but I kind of told everybody, I'm probably not going to do much more than just write the drafts. And that was, I think, again in 2023. So I wrote two drafts of the book three and book four of the series. And then as I started thinking about books five and six, I was like, I don't know that I really want to write those. I'm not sure that I would have as much useful to say because so much had changed in the landscape and my priorities had shifted. So I kind of put those on hold. And that's where things sat for almost 2 years. I had stable draft complete, but of books three and four, and nothing in books five and six. I continued to get people asking me questions about what, you know, should you do, or are you ever going to publish these? And I had told my Kickstarter audience, by the way, if I ever do publish any of those four in any form, I'll honor all of my backers as if we had reached the stretch goals. Cause I don't want people to feel like they missed out or something like that. So I had it in the back of my mind, maybe someday. Well, you fast forward to maybe about 2 or 3 weeks ago. I've been messing around. I've been doing a lot more with AI, like having conversations with ChatGPT to help plan out various aspects of my work or plan out writing or things. I've started doing some fiction writing. So I'm using it to help me kind of organize those thoughts and edit things. And I had a conversation with ChatGPT, which sounds weird to say, but I had a conversation with ChatGPT and the topic came up about these old books and how I was like, and how I had just recently taken a draft of that Monads and Friends book and put it out. And ChatGPT was like, you should totally do that. You should put out the Unbooks. And it literally came up with that phrase. It was like, put out the Unbooks. They're not fully finished, but they're still valuable, right? And I was like, oh my God, that's genius. Why hold myself to this higher bar of like, if they're not perfect, I'm never going to put them out. Just take whatever I have and put them out. And further, as I refined the idea, I thought, well, I'll write a really short, like 5 or 10 page version of each of books five and six that says kind of what I would have written about, but like explains why I'm not going to write the whole book and gives a little bit of a glimpse into the topic. So that's what this book is. It's the final volume, the final chapter for You Don't Know JS. It's the second edition and it's all the rest. It's books three through six, but they're unbooks. They're not really fully finished, although three and four are full length drafts. And all together, the compendium is a little over 400 pages. So it's plenty of content. It's not like a, you know, 10 page little trivial thing. It's plenty of content, but I think there's value in having that content brought together. Also a little hint for folks, the stuff that I wrote for books five and six, those unbooks, those few pages that I wrote for each of those, I'm not putting that anywhere else other than in this book. I normally have all of my stuff out on GitHub. I decided that would be an exclusive just for this Unbooks ebook. So that's the only place you'll be able to get any of those thoughts is through this. But I decided let's keep that bar lower. I love that that's always the spirit of Leanpub, is that you can aspire to hire, but you don't have this huge barrier to entry. Like you just, you know, have to go from 0 to 60. So leaning into that, relaxing some of my own personal obsessions. And I thought, this is a really good idea. Let's put this out. And that's what the Unbooks are, is that final kind of the final word that I have to say about JavaScript and about the You Don't Know JS series, bringing again an 11-year journey to a conclusion.
Yeah, well, thanks very much for sharing that really great story. You know, all the highs and lows, the kind of like, you know, big successes and setbacks, the fights and things like that. You know, anyone who's talked to authors knows that every book, you know, has a story, but like a series of books that's taken place over a decade will definitely have many, many stories. Just before we move on, I just wanted to sort of articulate, yeah, you know, as you said, you know, it's called the Unbooks. They're sort of not entirely finished, but these, you only write when you've thought about things a great deal. And there's 400 pages of content. The subjects are objects and classes, Unbook 3, types and grammar, Unbook 4, sync and async, Unbook 5, and ES.Next and Beyond, Unbook 6. Lots of really great content in there.
I really hope that people dig through it. I said this on other launch videos, but I'll repeat it for the benefit of this audience. Because almost all the content that I ever write is usually out on GitHub, I don't really look at selling books as a way to sell my content. I look at books as a way to sell an experience. So if you want to access the content, with the small exception of those books five and six that are exclusive, if you want to access that content, the drafts of book three and four are still available for free. You can still read them. They're still Creative Commons licensed, all of that. So I don't want there to be a barrier for people to read the content, but I do regularly get people asking for a more polished experience, which they can open up in a reader and has page numbers and things are, you know, nicely formatted and there's chapter breaks and things like that. That makes the experience of reading a lot more pleasant for most folks. And so I recognize the value in that, and that's what I'm selling. It's not just the content, but it's giving you the work that I did to give you this experience so that you can pull it onto your ebook reader and read it offline or something like that. And I hope that people see the value in that. You know, if this is 4 books, or let's call it 3 point something, you know, books or something like that, if that's how much content this is, I normally would have, you know, retail sold each one of them for $20 to $30. And I'm selling the entire thing for $9.99. That's just because I do think that there is value in the reading experience, and I want to put value there. I don't want to discount that effort. But, you know, I hope that people find that a really approachable last word in the series, instead of feeling like I was trying to do a big money grab at the end or something.
And as I look at the book's landing page on Leanpub right now, it's currently under embargo.
So we are about to, I'm going to literally click the publish button as we go, and it's now doing all of its lean pubby things. And we should hopefully have a fully published version of the book here within a few seconds of us continuing our conversation. But it's now available for sale. My Kickstarter backers had it exclusive about 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
And I gave them an opportunity to have that, you know, in private. And now the whole world gets to see it here on Leanpub, and I'm thrilled. I'm excited that You Don't Know JS has said what I think I want to say about the JavaScript language. I feel tremendously grateful for all the opportunities I've had to speak to that world and to that community. And I hope that people continue to find value from it.
Definitely. I'm sure they will. It's a really great book. I just refreshed my page and I can see that it's live on Leanpub. There'll be a link obviously in the video and any sort of, you know, tweet or post or whatever you see about this video. So Kyle, thank you very much for taking the time to do this launch video about You Don't Know JS Yet, the Unbooks, and telling us the really amazing story of these books that are such great value to all your readers.
Thanks very much. Appreciate it. Happy reading.